Hi, this is Nagendra. Welcome to this series of videos where I will try to explain all the tools and small utilities that I use to make my virtual instructor-led classes a bit more interesting than usual. In the first video, I'm going to talk about the built-in facility in Windows 10, which is called as virtual desktops. These help us maintain a neat and clean user interface while working on multiple windows at the same time. So let's get started and explore the feature virtual desktops in Windows 10. The feature of virtual desktops has been available with the help of third-party plugins earlier as well, but in Windows 10 we have a built-in feature which is called virtual desktops or tasks view. If you look at the taskbar, there is this little button called task view. If you click on this one, well, it shows you all the open applications. Let me get rid of these unwanted ones. Alright, so right now I have a presentation open on my desktop, and let us say you're presenting something full screen, and while it is in full screen you want to show maybe a piece of lab demo in between. So usually what you'll have to do, you will escape or exit from this full screen video presentation, slideshow presentation, and then you will open up that lab page. But instead of doing that, you can switch to a different workspace altogether. Press Control, Window and D keys together, and that takes you to a new desktop. Now here you can connect to your lab and demonstrate whatever you want to do. So let me just open up something for a demo. So let's say that's my remote lab and I can perform some activities over here, right? If I want to switch back to my presentation, I can press Window, Control and left arrow key again, and it brings me back to the previous desktop. In this example, I showed you two virtual desktops. On one I'm doing presentation, and on the second one I just try to demo something on the lab. Imagine if you have too many activities to be done. If you have maybe let's say a course where you have multiple lab setups and you need to switch between them, you can allocate one desktop for each one of them, right? So that will make it interesting. To make things more easier to perceive for people who are joining in a class from a remote location, when you are switching these desktops frequently, it may be a little bit distracting for them. They might get lost on which desktop where we are right now. To make it easier for people to understand on which desktop you are and to switch easily, to give you more keyboard shortcuts, there is another utility called as Virtual Desktop Enhancer. Again, this is a third party utility, but it's interesting. Let's see how it works. So I'm adding one more desktop here, and let me start my utility. It is called Virtual Desktop Enhancer. So clicking on this, now you see what it showed. I switched back to desktop number one automatically. I'm switching to desktop two now. What does it say? It says data center. So that's a label I have put for desktop number two. Let's go to desktop number three. It says branch one. So usually I use this setup for virtual deliveries of my Nuaj courses, where I demonstrate data center settings and branch settings for the different solutions. And I can switch back to desktop number one, where I have my reference material or presentation. The labels that you are able to see here can be switched dynamically. You can rename them. So Window F2 key gives me an option to rename the desktop. So let us say I'll call it as presentation. Okay, so now when I switch to the desktops, I'll see the updated label. So I come back to desktop number one and it says presentation. So that way I can keep on using different workspaces to keep them neat and clean, one application or one task on one, and I can give a visual cue to people joining from remote locations, and they will be able to keep track on which desktop we are right now. So that's with the built-in feature of Windows called virtual desktops, and a little enhancement added with the help of Virtual Desktop Enhancer. There are much more things you can do with the Desktop Enhancer actually. So if you see this little icon here, it is representing the Virtual Desktop Enhancer. I can make some predefined configurations. I can reload the existing settings on top of this. I can also automate things because I have done some batch programming for this. So you can see here I have my regular config. I have a configuration for my Nuaj classes, and if I click on my icon over here, it loads that settings script in the background, and when I reload the settings, you can see it says present over here. If I change the settings and I go to my other setup, I reload the settings again, and you can say it says reference material. So the desktop backgrounds, the keyboard shortcuts that you want to use, the labels for the desktop that you want to use, they can all be customized in an initialization file and can be kept, you know, ready to apply. You can make little batch files, just execute the batch files, and it changes the configuration of Virtual Desktop Enhancer so that you get different settings based on your course delivery, based on your lab requirements, and you can customize that. So I hope this feature will help you customize your desktops to facilitate better presentation in virtual environment. Stay tuned for more little features. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.